students, today we are going to observe and do an experiment to understand one of the most important chemical that is present in living cells. Now, Divya, what is the basic unit of life? Basic unit of life is a cell. Right? Yes, and these cells are broadly as animal cells or plant cells. There are also bacteria which also have got cells.
Yes.
But what governs these cells is a chemical substance. So therefore, chemistry is very important. It is very rightly called as the mother of all sciences. Right? This chemistry we have to try to understand about this and the import of these chemicals in each and every cell.
Yes.
Right? And all living cells are doing so many different works in a very flawless manner.
Yes.
They also reproduce.
Yes.
Right? They produce increase in their numbers.
And
what is that substance which is there, which is of greatest importance?
DNA.
That is DNA. DNA is a short form. What is the full form of our DNA?
Deoxyribonucleic acid.
It's a deoxyribose nucleic acid. What is it by deoxyribose? Is there any meaning to this deoxyribose? Is there any other variety of that?
Yeah, sir. Actually, DNA is actually made up of three components. One is the nitrogenous base. Second, we have the ribose sugar. And then it is actually attached with one another with a phosphoric acid. At the second position of ribose sugar, we actually doesn't have an oxygen. Oxygen is removed at the second position, which we actually call it as deoxyribose.
Deoxy means removal of oxygen.
Removal of oxygen.
And other varieties?
RNA.
Or ribosynucleic acid. So deoxyribonucleic acid and ribose nucleic acids are two very important chemicals. Right? And they are present in all living cells.
Yes.
Is it right?
Yes, sir.
Now, all
yes,
living cells, they are there. Right? And we have to take an example of this. What are we going to take today?
Today, we are taking onion as our source of DNA, sir.
Onion is living or not living?
Living.
It is
definitely living, coming from plant.
Yes, definitely. So, we have taken a specimen, easily available, low cost, and
yes,
can be done very easily.
Yes,
okay?
Sir. Yeah.
What other chemicals we require, Divya?
We need a detergent, sir.
We require, what does a detergent do there?
Actually, it will disturb the cell membranes.
It will disturb, it will break down the cell, because you have to go inside the cells.
Yes.
So, because the plant cells have got cell wall, it's a very tough material.
Yes.
We need to break down that.
Yeah.
Animal cells are different. They don't have this cell wall, they have only cell membrane. So to disturb this cell wall, you require a strong chemical agent.
Yes,
that is our
detergent
powder, which you use in our homes.
Yes,
right? This detergent is a very important chemical.
Yes,
then what else we require?
NaCl solution.
NaCl is our table salt.
Yes,
we got sodium chloride solution.
Sodium chloride.
Right? That is a solution we're going to require.
Yes.
What else we require?
A mortar and pestle to grind it.
For mechanically grinding that, why do we grind them? It is to increase the surface area.
Yes,
right? Make more area available for the action of the chemicals to grate them mechanically, break down things mechanically so the chemicals can go and act on them.
Yes.
And then we require
a strainer to strain.
Yes. There's a strainer here. So we require only the extract of it. We don't require the remaining part of it. So what is going to be useful of those cells, we are going to take it.
Yes.
What else we require for other chemicals?
Importantly, ethanol, sir.
Ethanol.
Yes.
Now this ethyl alcohol is the commonly called as ethanol, and that is also required. What does ethanol do?
It will extract the DNA from the source.
Yes, the ethanol is a chemical substance that is going to extract DNA which you are going to take out of this strained material.
Yes.
So, shall we start?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so first we will take
mortar and pestle.
And we will take grated onions.
Yes.
We will take a few pieces of them.
Yes.
And mortar and pestle. We will grate them mechanically to break down.
Yes.
So, watch, Divya is taking a few pieces of onions, grated?
Yes.
Yes. And then we'll add some water?
Directly we'll add
soap solution?
Yes.
Yes. What did we say soap is going to be useful for? Detergent will break down the cell walls. Cell walls are tough material, right? That makes the plant cells very strong.
NaCl.
Yes. And we also need salt. What does salt do? Yeah, by osmotic process, it will take out the things, right? All of you have studied the process of osmosis?
Yes, sir.
Yes. We'll make a salt solution?
Yes, sir.
By dissolving our table salt, small quantity.
Yeah.
Divya is adding salt solution to mortar and pestle and mechanically will grate it. So we have grated this. That now this has got grated onion, detergent solution and salt solution. Three chemicals mechanically mixed thoroughly. We'll take this grated solution and we want to strain it now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes. So what is coming out here is the solution here, right? The supernatant. We are going to keep it here and this is what we are going to take in this dish. So, shall we add a small quantity of this to the plate?
Yes, sir.
Okay. That should be okay or some more?
Yes, sir.
Now, I want you to observe it here carefully that this is of uniform consistency.
Yes.
What is the structure of DNA?
Double helical structure.
Right? You take two loops of thread and wind them in a helical order, right? Intertwining into them, and that will become a structure here. It's a very interesting structure. As a student of biology, whenever we have seen DNA, we are always amazed how wonderful the structure is now stored in our body. Right? So here you find that is completely clear, right? We'll take a little more.
Yes, sir.
So that we'll fill the entire floor of this plate.
Yes.
And the structure you can see here, it is very uniform.
Yes.
Now to extract them from the cells, we need to now add a chemical substance.
Ethanol.
Could you add some ethanol, Divya?
Yes.
Yes, we added some ethanol. And in a matter of few minutes, right, the action is so strong that you can just agitate it slightly. And the entire solution, which was earlier of uniform consistency, is now breaking down into these fibrous structures. Can we have a glass rod?
Yes.
Yes, please point out this fibrous structure strands here.
Yes.
Oh, beautiful.
The double helical structure.
Very, very nicely seen.
Yes.
Right?
Yes.
That is the entire strand you see. So
yes,
from
sir.
A very uniformly distributed medium here, right, you could say by addition of this ethyl alcohol, you could extract this DNA, and this DNA is now very clearly visible as clear strands, right?
Yes, sir.
Very amazing, right?
Yes.
So, and this deoxyribose nucleic acid is the entire code of your body,
yes.
Right? Its arrangement of these different components will determine, yes, what events will take place in what manner, at what time, and for how long.
Yes.
Right? So, as I said, chemistry is so important that you need to understand this very, really well. And therefore, it is rightly said that chemistry is mother of all sciences. Chemistry is mother of all sciences.
All sciences.
Right. So, if chemistry is mother, who should be father?
Biology.
Now, mathematics is the father of all
mathematics.
Sciences. So, therefore, without mother and father, you are an orphan. So, you need to understand your mother and father of science very well, chemistry and mathematics.
Okay.
So you can see his DNA beautifully extracted here, and you can find it. Okay.
Yes,
so this was a very simple method of extraction of DNA from very commonly available material like onion. Right? Very commonly used material. Every household has got a detergent solution.
Yes, sir.
Your kitchen has got your sodium chloride. Water is there, plenty of available. Ethyl alcohol is what you have to get. You go to any chemist shop and ask for rubbing alcohol or surgical spirit, you can get it over there.
Yes.
So with these simple chemicals, you can see this, you are able to extract this fantastic material which is inside the cells. Now you can see them as strands. This is
extraction of DNA from onion.
Thank you.
Thank you.